You're on mute.
Morning, Paul. Good morning, Mike. Good morning, everyone.
Well, it's good to see you, Paul.
And you, slightly bizarre circumstances.
It certainly is strange circumstances, Paul. Your final Sunday with us, and thank you very much for joining me for this interview that we could record. How are you feeling at the moment?
Ah!
Well, that's so good to hear, Paul. Thank you for that. It's been a strange old time while you've been a curate. I really enjoyed having you here, but in a pandemic, it's been a strange time to be a curate. So I just wondered how you feel about how the last 3 years have gone.
Scared, I've battled my fears, I've struggled. Lost sleep, lost hope, lost my way, lost my mind.
And I'm glad it's been a very positive experience for you. It is a real shame that you are moving on. Sorry, what's that you say?
Good news!
It really is, and when we mentioned it to the congregation, they all shouted,
good news!
That you had found a new post to go to, and everyone's very excited for you. Now, of course, we've had to face a lot of challenges over the last few years, not least doing online services, and I have to say that you took to them really well right from the very beginning.
Mum, look, I'm on Facebook Live.
Yes, I'm sure you'll agree, a real natural. Now, Paul, I know an important part of your ministry is preaching, and you put a lot of effort into it. How would you sum up your time as a preacher here in our churches?
You could be forgiven for being a bit underwhelmed.
It still feels weird talking to somebody that's behind you and having no idea what they're doing. Go and make yourself comfortable,
will do.
Which is what I'll tell everybody else to do before the sermon starts.
And I could go on.
Oh yes, Paul, if I could just stop you there. Yes, I know that you can go on. Go on to greater things, and we're all rooting for you in that you may go on to greater things. Now, I know that you've been very appreciative of everyone at St. Mary's and St. Luke's and to all those who have helped you in many special ways. But you wanted to say something particularly, didn't you, about our ex-warden, Joy. What was it you wanted to say about her again, Paul?
And I want to say from the start that Joy is not about laughing all the time. Joy is not some stand-up routine. Joy is from God.
Well, thank you, Paul. I'm sure Joy will be pleased to hear your thoughts on her. Now, as you come to the end of your ministry here at St. Mary's and St. Luke's, I wonder what you are looking forward to in the future.
That we would have a massive knees up, a huge celebration.
Well, yes, why not? I was thinking a bit more long term and plans for ministry, but yeah, let's have a knees up and a celebration.
Oh well,
nailed that one, didn't I?
So, sorry, what was it you did last time you left somewhere?
We laughed and laughed and laughed. Yes, we're Southern, so we laugh.
Listen up, mortal.
Okay, no problem. We'll have a party after the service. Well, thank you, Paul, for taking the time to do this interview with me. It's such a busy schedule. I'm just thinking as we come towards the end of this interview and the end of your time here with us, is there a message you'd like to leave with us?
God has told you what is good. So do it and learn who God is and what God is about.
Let us keep praying. It might be all we can do, but prayer is powerful. And in praying, we will know the Holy Spirit on us. Let us keep trusting. In trusting, we can look forward in faith. Let us keep hoping, hoping in the light and salvation for the world. Because hope in Jesus never disappoints us. Good news! We sing our final belter, to God be the glory. I think I just about nailed that one, didn't I? Thank you.